Holy crap, dude! Haven't you ever heard of knocking first? You ready for part two right now? Can I just... Well, let me just... Okay. Well, let me finish this number two, and then we'll get started on that number two. So, when we ended part one, the Nomo had basically just left Earth, leaving Earth and its life forms to evolve and develop at their own pace. Which is exactly what they did for millions of years. That is, up to about 433,000 years ago, give or take 10 or 20 millennium. That's approximately when these butthead aliens called the Anunnaki started showing up. Anunnaki, which means those who from heaven to earth came. Well, they came all right. They came and made a mess of things. The story that was more or less made popular by the human being known as Zachariah Sitchin is that the Anunnaki came to earth to mine gold in order to save their planet's dwindling atmosphere. While Zachariah had to fill in a few blanks with an educated guess here and there, the vast majority of his source information came from cuneiform tablets. These cuneiform tablets were flattened clay that were inscribed using a stylus, then fired and hardened. They were first discovered in the late 1800s in the ruins of an ancient Middle Eastern palace. The ruins were located in northern Iraq, which used to be called Mesopotamia. The land in Mesopotamia between the Tigris and Euphrates rivers was known as the Cradle of Civilization. Huh, I wonder how the golfing was back then. Anyways, the palace ruins are believed to be that of Ashurbanipal, the last of the great kings of Assyria. Over 30,000 of the clay tablets were found in the library chamber of the palace ruins. Man, that's a lot. And only a small percentage have been translated so far. But among the tablets that have been translated, they found everything from bills of sale and deeds to property, marriage licenses, and just general public records type of stuff. Shoot, they even found beer recipes. You don't suppose that they had happy hour down at the pub too, do ya? But by far the coolest stuff they found in these tablets, yes, even cooler than my alien drummer butt, are the epic tales and stories that echo biblical writings but from a completely different perspective. They talk about Noah's flood. They talk about the Tower of Babel. They talk about the Garden of Eden. Yes, E-D-I-N. And yes, they talk about the Anunnaki, the alien race coming to Earth to mine gold. Also found in that library is the Enuma Elish, otherwise known as the Seven Tablets of Creation, which is where we get the story of Marduk crashing into Tiamat, breaking it apart. Here's a little fun fact for you. Marduk was king of the gods, and Tiamat was known as the Chaos Dragon. In the 80s cartoon Dungeons & Dragons, the evil dragon's name was, you guessed it, Tiamat. Okay, let's get back to the Anunnaki. The cuneiform tablets say that the Anunnaki came from an invader planet called Nibiru. Nibiru was also called the Planet of the Crossing. It's called an invader planet because it wasn't always in your solar system, but it is now. At some point, it became ensnared by your sun's gravitational net and pulled in. 1 year to you Earthlings is 365 days. But 1 year to those on Nibiru is equivalent to, drumroll please,
1 for the money, 2 for the show.
Okay, all right, never mind. Let's get back to it. I don't even remember where I was at. Oh yeah, the Anunnaki. 1 year for the Anunnaki was like 3,600 years to you Earthlings. This is why they always thought they were immortal, but they're not. The Anunnaki just lived for a freaking long time. The Anunnaki were far more advanced hundreds of thousands of years ago than even you Earthlings are today. But just like you, they also damaged their atmosphere. Dang dumbest smart aliens I know. At least they were smart enough to figure out how to patch the holes in their atmosphere. They needed monoatomic gold, heated up and then suspended in the atmosphere, patching the holes. I'll explain what's so special about gold in another video in this series. They just needed it. You ever wonder why human beings obsess over gold? I did too until I learned about the Anunnaki. It will all start to make sense as we work our way through the rest of this video series. There you have it. Gold is why the Anunnaki came to Earth and started causing problems. And as a matter of fact, they are still here and still manipulating mankind. In part 3, I'll get into the kingship of Nibiru and how they actually found gold on Earth, or Ki. And a closer look at how they actually got to Earth and the start of the mining operations. Like always, I'll put links in the description to some of my resources and other cool alien stuff. Until next time, I'm Alien Adam. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get all my new videos. We'll see you in part 3.